The mobile market currently is a pretty cluttered space. A lot of phones that are being released these days are very similar. With that being said, it doesn't mean that phones aren't interesting anymore. Yes, we do have folding phones as well, which is, yes, an interesting topic as well. But we do have phones now with a new CPU, the Snapdragon 870. The Snapdragon 870 is basically a boosted 865 Plus, last year's flagship chip. So that means that you get a great performance out of a phone that is quite a lot lower in price than a flagship, and some would even vouch that the 865 Plus was the better CPU than the 888 that we currently have. So if you want a pure performer, that 870 CPU is really something that is interesting, especially for the price that you are paying. However, the question is, at what cost? Well, let's find out in this full review of the Poco F3 that comes with that Snapdragon 870. Let's find out in this review of it and see what you get for the price itself. So before we start talking about the device itself, talk about specs and all my opinions about the device itself, let's talk about the design itself as well, because for me, design really matters. In terms of the design, I kind of like it. The camera hump has like this two-step hump, with one part having this thick glass effect that holds the fluorescent sensor, and then the second step holds the camera sensors. And while it doesn't stand out as design, it looks clean and sophisticated, unless you hold it, because it leaves fingerprint marks faster than you can hit like on this video. Either way, because of the back being really reflective, it does make that dirt and fingerprints are your worst enemy on this phone. So I would advise a case on this one. And then let's quickly talk about the ports. Yes, it comes with, of course, your USB-C, your dual speakers, but sadly, there is no 3.5mm headphone jack. While you do get a dongle inside, there is no 3.5mm headphone jack, and that really is a shame, especially for a phone like this. Talking about that stereo speaker setup, it is actually quite decent when it comes to the audio performance as well. Here an example. So let's discuss the overall specs now. The phone comes with a 6.67 inch 120 Hz AMOLED display with a Full HD Plus resolution. Its peak brightness is around 1300 and it does have an IP53 rating. You get that Snapdragon 870 CPU with 5G support as well. 128GB of internal memory or 256GB internal memory. With 6GB of RAM, you get 128GB of internal memory, and with 8GB of RAM, you get that 256GB of internal memory. Both are UFS 3.1. In terms of camera setup, you get a main camera that is a 48MP sensor, which is the Sony IMX582, which is a very popular sensor and has been used in a lot of phones, though I would have preferred a different sensor for this. But as stated, this is more aimed at CPU performance than the camera, but we'll discuss that later. You get an 8MP ultra-wide sensor and a 5MP telemacro. You can record video up to 4K and 30 frames per second, but also 1080p at 60 frames per second. The front camera is a 20MP sensor, and in terms of battery, it's a 4520mAh battery. So, what does this mean when it comes to down to using this phone? Honestly, the speed just feels like a flagship. It speeds through everything, and I haven't had any bad experience in terms of speed and in terms of playing games or anything like that, and when it comes to heating up, I have no experience with that as well. Of course though, with every phone, software is a large part of it. For myself, I have some things that I would like to see better on MUI, mainly the way you swipe away notifications from left to right instead from right to left. Most of them do it both sides though. In my experience, however, with the Mi 11 Ultra that does come with that 12.5 MUI, it does allow me to swipe from left to right and right to left as well. And then we get to, of course, the app drawer as well. Not the biggest fan of having separated categories. I prefer just simply having pages in my app drawer. But again, this is a preference. And while MUI isn't the best experience at the moment for mobile devices, I have to say that the growth has been really good. But at the beginning I asked, at what cost do you get that Snapdragon 870? Well, it doesn't cost a huge amount, if we don't calculate the lack of the 3.5 of course. But what I can tell you is that the camera sensor is an older sensor, but like every decent phone these days, in daytime pictures are fine. However, there is a feeling of having a filter on top of the images. It's kind of hard to explain, and of course at the end it's down to preference whether you like it or not, but it is a bit darker but less saturated and going for that bright stuff, which I do not prefer myself of course. But I will always of course showcase images and leave the judgment to yourself, because for everyone they have their own preference when it comes to images. A lot of people seem to like this filthy, ugly, saturated, bright image for some reason. Not saying you shouldn't like it, but you shouldn't. Jokes aside, this is a part that you somewhat have to judge yourself as well. I'm not gonna tell you what you should or shouldn't like, that's not my job. I'm here to inform you about what it does and how it performs. And I'm curious to see what you think about the daytime images here. Of course, then we also have low light. Now, while the same sensor is on lower priced phones as well, a lot of current processing also comes from the CPU, and the Snapdragon 870 is a great chip for this, so the result is better than other phones that share that same sensor. But there are phones around this price that also perform better. In terms of video, like stated, you can record up to 4K and 30 frames per second, but of course also 1080p and 60 frames per second. So, at the end, the Poco F3 is an interesting and compelling package. I feel like the focus is mainly, as stated at the beginning of the video, the 870. And it really does well here. Yes, it uses a camera that is a little bit older and can be found on some other phones as well that are a lot cheaper. With that being said, however, this has the 870 inside. The 870 is not just for the speed of your phone, it's also for your camera performance as well. So there is some enhancement experience differences with this compared to some other cheaper phones that also uses that same sensor inside. With that being said, overall the performance is really solid on the Poco F3. There are some things that I would love to see different, but overall the experience is really smooth. The camera, it has something to it, but it isn't really true to life to begin with. But overall, I don't think the camera performance is bad by any means. It's just not the best performer out there for the price itself. But with that being said, if you really want a pure performer when it comes to the CPU and you love to play games and you love to do some heavy tasks on your phone, the Poco F3 is a really solid performer and I think you will be pleased with that. But of course, you have to keep something in mind. If you do enjoy playing games, it really is a shame that the headphone jack isn't on this phone. I feel like that really is a miss on a phone like this, and yes, you do get of course your dongle inside, but no 3.5mm headphone jack really is something that I wouldn't want to see on a phone like this. But with that being said, that's my own preference, and I know that I can rant a lot about that 3.5mm headphone jack, and I'm gonna keep doing it because for myself it's the better performance and of course the easier experience compared to Bluetooth. So, at the end, what do you think about the Poco F3? What do you think about the camera as well? And of course, the performance. What matters more to you? Do you feel like the camera performance is more important to you? Or do you feel like, of course, the CPU performance is more important to you? Let me know in the comments below, because honestly, I'm really interested in that. Either way, hope you enjoyed this review of the Poco F3. And of course, talk to you guys in the next.